Ashley here, and today I'm going to show you how to make liquid culture. Liquid culture is a great way to speed up colonization and preserve genetics. One downside to LCs is you can't see contamination, so checking viability on agar is best. To start, we need to make the lids. These lids are made of PP5 plastic, which means that you can sterilize them in a pressure cooker. They are 90 millimeters in size and fit on a 32-ounce mason jar. These plastic lids are great because they don't rust like the metal ones do. Now we need to drill two holes, one for the red injection port and one for the gas exchange filter. For the gas exchange port, I'm using a 5 1/32 drill bit, and we just drilled them directly on the mason jar and it worked really well. Then insert the 13 millimeter filter into the hole and it should be a nice snug fit. Then for the self-healing injection port, I used a 1/2 inch Forstner drill bit. Then screw the lid on a mason jar and drill the larger hole for the self-healing injection port. Finally, let's insert the self-healing injection port. Just pinch it and try to push it through the hole. And then from the other side, you can just kind of pull with your finger or your thumb around the edges, and then it'll just pop into place. Now that our lids are finished, we can start making our liquid culture. First, weigh out 8 grams of your liquid culture media. I am using a premix from Shroom Supply, but any extra light malt extract will work. Next, we need to put our magnetic mixer in the mason jar. It's very important that you put the mixer in before you sterilize your liquid culture. Then add your liquid culture media to the mason jar. I'm using a 32-ounce wide mouth mason jar. Then add 600 milliliters of water to the mason jar. Then thoroughly mix on a mixing plate until it's completely dissolved. Next, we need to strain the mix twice with a coffee filter. This helps remove a lot of the extra sediment sitting at the bottom. If you don't get all of the extra sediment at the bottom, don't worry, the mycelium will eventually eat it. I like to filter the liquid culture twice because this gets about 80% of the sediment at the bottom, and it comes out very clean and clear, which makes it a lot easier to see the mycelium growth. Then put the lid on and give it one last mix, and now we're ready to sterilize it. Next, place a piece of aluminum foil over the lid. Now we are ready to sterilize our liquid culture. Next, let's prepare the pressure cooker. Place the cleaning rack at the bottom for a spacer, and then add around 8 to 10 cups of water. I try to cover the spacer at the bottom. Then put your liquid culture mix in the pressure cooker and close the lid. Then sterilize for 45 minutes at 15 psi. After 45 minutes, turn off the stove and release the pressure. Finally, remove the liquid culture from the pressure cooker and let it cool down to room temperature. Cooling it down to room temperature can take anywhere from 12 to 24 hours. If you add a live culture or spores when the liquid culture is too hot, you can end up killing the mycelium. After it's cooled to room temperature, it's ready to go, and now we can add our live culture. Now it's time to add our live culture. It's best to be in front of a laminar flow hood or in a sterile environment. First, you want to pick a freshly harvested mushroom. I try to pick the biggest, strongest looking mushroom from the flesh in order to get the best genetics. First, carefully open the syringe and the needle, and then carefully screw on the needle to the syringe, trying to face everything towards the laminar flow being as sterile as possible. Next, you'll want to insert the needle into the red injection port and then suck up some of the liquid culture. You're sucking up some of the liquid culture because when you take the live culture as a biopsy in the needle, you need something to basically push it through the needle. Next, we're going to take our live culture. So you're going to want to take your mushroom and then carefully split the mushroom down the middle. And let it sit towards the laminar flow just in case you can't get a biopsy from one, you can use the other. Then remove the needle from the mason jar with the liquid culture in it, and then take a biopsy of your liquid of your mushroom. And I try to use the bottom of the mushroom. I heard that it can be the strongest part of that mushroom. Then you kind of want to twist your needle a little bit until you can get a chunk in there. This took me a really long time. I struggled. Then once you get a chunk, you'll insert the needle back into the red injection port and then push the live culture through the needle into the mason jar. Okay, you can see a small piece of the live culture right there. You just need a really small piece. You don't need anything big. There's also another piece. I actually got two. So that's be sufficient. Then over the next couple of days, you will start to see your mycelium grow. Here is the next day. All of that at the bottom is actually the sediment from the liquid culture media. And it looks like contamination, but it's actually not. And over the next couple of days, the mycelium actually starts to eat it, so it's not a big deal. You'll want to mix up your liquid culture every day, just kind of hand mix it. And then we can start to see a chunk. It'll start to float around here. It takes me a minute. Okay, here is a chunk of the mycelium, and you can see a tiny bit of growth on the outside of it. That's the first day of growth. It looks pretty good. It's not too bad. That's a better angle. That looks really good right there. You can see it all the way around. Then this is the fifth day growth. And each day, like I said, you just want to give it a quick mix. And you can see that the sediment is slowly getting eaten by the mycelium. And this stuff grows really fast. So it's already starting to break up into, 5 to 10 pieces, and definitely noticing growth on all of those pieces. So everything that you see there is mycelium growth. Okay, this is day 6. And the mycelium is really starting to clump there together. And this is day 7. And I think that we have enough to take a test to check for contamination. So that's the next thing that we're going to do is go ahead and test to see if our liquid culture is clean. And I'm going to test on agar. Now we're ready to test our liquid culture on agar. First, clean off the red self-healing injection port with an alcohol pad. Then start to prepare your syringe. Open the syringe and the needle facing the laminar flow, trying to be as sterile as possible, and then screw the top of the needle onto the syringe. Next, insert the needle into the red self-healing injection port. Then carefully try to suck up some of the liquid live culture in the mason jar. And this is actually a lot harder said than done. I try to swirl the live culture up to the top of the mason jar, which makes it a little bit easier to try to get. But it takes some time working the mycelium around in the mason jar until you actually get a good chunk inside of the syringe in order to test it on the agar. After you get a decent chunk in the syringe, next, test it on the agar. So here you can see that there's quite a bit of liquid in the syringe, and I don't really think that you need all of that liquid, so I actually try to squirt some of it out and only get the piece of culture on the agar. If it's too liquidy, that can actually cause additional contamination. So you can see me here, like, I really get most of the liquid until the live culture is right at the tip, and then squeeze it onto the agar. But it's okay if you test, the actual water in the syringe too, because we want to make sure that that's contam free as well. Then with these live cultures, the next day you should see mycelial growth. It's super fast. These live cultures are so quick. So there you go. Go ahead and wrap up your petri dishes with parafilm, and you guys are ready to go. Okay, this is the next day from my agar trays. Sorry that the video quality is so dark, but you can see that the mycelium has already started to grow and has a pretty good chunk started, and no contamination. And then this is 5 days later, and the mycelial growth is definitely a lot bigger and still no contamination. So we are good to go. Yay! After checking for contamination, now we are ready to inoculate our grain spawn bag with our liquid culture. First, I recommend being in front of a laminar flow hood or in a sterile environment. Then, sanitize everything before you start. This liquid culture has been colonizing for about 3 weeks, and it's pretty much covering the whole mason jar, which is the perfect time to go ahead and take a syringe of it and inoculate our grain spawn. Next, we need to prepare the syringe. First, open the syringe and then the needle facing the laminar flow, and then screw the needle on top of the syringe. Then you will want to insert the needle into the self-healing injection port and suck up some of the liquid culture into the syringe, filling the syringe. Then carefully remove the needle from the self-healing injection port, and you should see a bunch of liquid culture in there. You can see it in there. And carefully inoculate the grain spawn bag. You'll want to put about 2 to 4 cc's of liquid culture in your bag, kind of inserting it in all of the corners of the bag. Careful not to puncture through the back of the bag. Then give the bag a quick mix and you are ready to go. Lastly, you can take a piece of micro pore tape and just cover the self-healing, the black self-healing injection port on the spawn bag. Then the next day you will see growth. So this is day one, the next day after I inoculated, and there's just a tiny bit of mycelium growth. But definitely growth. And then this is day 2. And this is day 4. And you can really see that the bag is really starting to take to the liquid culture, and then there are spots of mycelial growth popping up all over the bag. And this is day 6. So over the next 30 days, you're going to see your bag colonize. And then once it fully colonized, you can move it into your monotub. Thank you guys so much for watching, and if you have any questions, please feel free to put them in the comments. You can reach out to me on Instagram or Facebook. Also, please subscribe to my new channel, Ashley Schumer, where I'll be posting new mushroom content soon. Thank you!